It seems like each year we get to enjoy so many different kinds of big games. And in many of those instances, those games provide familiar experiences or ones that try something different, or they invite us into many of the sequels. Then there are those rare titles that honestly try to do something a bit different and provide the player with something so unique to them. This can be from how they are structured, or how they tell their story, or how the gameplay mechanics are used. Either way, these games are very memorable for the different approach that they try. This year, we saw the release of Control from Remedy Studios, and it's one of 2019's most unique games. The use of powers and how the world looks and operates is very weird, yet thoroughly engaging. I would also put another title into this category this year. The Sinking City is a game that focused on putting you into the shoes of a private investigator. While it does have familiar elements with its open world and combat, the most interesting elements are with its investigation mechanics, and the Lovecraftian inspiration that really makes us stand out. I really enjoyed the investigation aspects of the game. This is honestly where the gameplay excels. There are many cases and optional cases that you will solve throughout the game, and how these cases operate give the player an immersive feeling of being a private investigator. There are instances where you need to piece together a crime scene and put it in the right order. This is pretty engaging to do as you're trying to craft the scene in the correct order and figure out what actually happened before you arrived. Along with this, there are many instances where you need to find a new lead or a location of a place that you need to investigate. But the game doesn't just hand you your next location with an objective marker. You will need to do some searching yourself to find the new location, or even look in the many city archives to figure out what to do next. Then you have the expected sequences of talking to people to try and find additional clues. There's even some choice in how you conclude some of these cases, adding that personal sense of choice to the game. All of these elements make for an involving and hands-off experience that really makes you feel like an investigator. On top of all of this, you have dark forces that are at work and some really interesting mysteries within the stories. The game features additional gameplay moments with action sequences with shooting. The combat is serviceable and definitely is an area that could use improvement. The frame rate is another area that could have used improvement, as you'll experience many frame rate dips throughout the game. There are areas that could be improved, but the investigation part of the game is the main focus of the gameplay, and it's really good. I have been playing some of this on the recent Switch version. While it shares some of the issues from the other versions, I'm actually kind of impressed with how well this runs on the Switch. The investigation elements are the real hook here, and this all creates a flawed yet very memorable experience. I highly recommend you check this one out.